Honey is the most popular natural sweetener in the world, and global trade in bee products is worth millions of dollars every year. Due to its diverse use, the world consumption of honey is so huge, its supply barely matches its demands. Africa consumes more than three times the amount of honey it produces, aside Ethiopia, Kenya, and Tanzania. Who produces most of the continent's honey? Other large markets like Nigeria and South Africa have a lot of unmet demand for bee product. Beekeeping as an agroforestry practice has not been given much attention in our country. There is increasing demand for honey in Nigeria and the world at large, but the business of apiculture is still relatively very low. This is saddening because apiculture is one of the most lucrative businesses that has no negative impact on the environment. On Rural Matters today, we seek to explore the business opportunities in apiculture or beekeeping, various uses of the product, the global market for bee products, species of bee best used for rearing, and the constraints militating against the success of apiculture as a business.
Rural Matters, making your community better.
Our search for answers led us to St. Anthony Catholic Church, Isiama Afaruku Ibeku, in Umuahia North Local Government Area in Abia State. Afara is a host community of Flow 94.9 FM and other business entities, including the present Abia State Government House. It was a short but resourceful journey from Flow FM Broadcasting House at Factory Road to St. Anthony Catholic Church, where we received a Roman Catholic priest, Reverend Father Tobias Uke, the parish priest and a passionate beekeeper. From the parish house, we joined him to one of his farms, where he gave us details about beekeeping.
Okay, even though I may start by explaining briefly what that means, beekeeping is just simply the science of keeping bees or rearing bees to tap honey and other honeybee byproducts. There are so many of them, like propolis, bee wax, to mention but a few. I started this 23 years ago, 1997, at Seat of Dom Seminary. One of our priests, Reverend Father Innocent Njowan, went for the short training at Ishiago, short-term training, and when he came back to the seminary, he announced that those who had interest could join, and I joined since that time. We are doing it until after ordination in 2007. I had the opportunity of attending further trainings, about five international training workshops on beekeeping, to get advanced knowledge of beekeeping. Usually, we bet the hive. I will show you a hive later, how it looks like. We have two major modern hives we are using now, the Langstroth hive, and also the bee, the Kenyan Toba hive. These are the major two kind of hives we are using as a modern hive. So you bait it with what we call attractor, anything that could attract the bees, and they come into it in trying to forage. They go into it and begin to build there. When they mature, you harvest the honey, you extract the honey, you process the comb to wax and other byproducts. Usually we have an attire that we call the bee suit, which is covered just like overall with veil. You put it a hand glove, and sometimes you can also go without hand glove, because when you are relaxed, when you go there with relaxed mind, they will not sting you. But when you are anxious and you are afraid, your body secretes this hormone adrenaline, which they perceive naturally, and they begin to sting you. But if you go there relaxed, you can even go with bare hand and, you know, harvest everything and come out. Very well, there, you put on anything like, as you mentioned, if you use anything that could, you can make them very much aggressive. So if you are going there, just go natural. Avoid any cosmetic, anything that could, you know, distract them. Just go there natural so that they will not sting you so much or they will not be aggressive. Well, if you bait the hive and they are attracted within the first 1 month, so they require about 3 months to build the comb. After that 3 months, from the fourth month, they're already depositing honey. Means if you are so lucky and you just get your honey in the first month, highest, within a period of 4, 5, 6 months, you get your first harvest. Yeah, one hive, a colony, can give you at least 10 liters of honey. And in some cases, can harvest more than once a year, depending on the environment. If you have a lot of vegetation and foraging source, you can harvest more than once. Normally you harvest around from ending of November, but the major honey flow begins from February. Yeah, because it's the dry season and they move about, you know, rainy season, you know, obstructs their movement. Because if they go out and when the rain falls, you know, their wing will stick, they can't fly. So most of the time, they prefer to stay indoors, I mean in the hive, during the rainy season. And when they stay, they begin to lick the honey they stored in the dry season.
Okay.
So that's why, even if you are harvesting, you don't harvest everything by the month of April, because after April, you are going to May, June. So you don't harvest all the honey you see in April. You reserve some for them so that when the rains are much, they find something to be, you know, feeding on before the major season. Yes, when we get the honey we sell, already people, we are not even meeting up with demand, because people have known the difference between original honey and what people are building with, mixing with molasses and sugar. So those who know the value, even they pay ahead of time. So we get a lot of honey, but within a little time, it finishes. For instance, people have been calling me for the past 1 month every day, looking for the Toba Agro honey. But we don't have it again because we don't go into the factory that we begin to mix up something. This is nature, we depend on nature. Exactly, we are, I know my business is at stake, so I can't even go into internal adulteration. We go, we harvest from the hive and process as it is naturally. So if you are taking, natural, pure and unadulterated honey. Yes.
The value of global trade in honey and bees products is over $600 million every year. Most people seem to think honey is the only valuable product bees make. Well, you'll be amazed to know that honeybees produce up to 6 different high-demand products used in a range of industries, from food processing to medicine.
Yes, because 1 kilo of a bee wax is about 2,000 naira. So, and you can get at least 1.5 kilo of bee wax from one colony after harvesting, at least between that and 2 kilograms, so kgs. So you can sell each of them at least 2,000 naira per kilo. That is more to be commercialized. And people who are into textile industry, polish, candle, and others, they buy it. Well, already, I don't have my farm here. I'm here because I'm a priest, and we go on location. We are posted to anywhere within the diocese. My farm is located at Ogubi Orocha Idimabam Aruchukwu FGA. So that is the major farm. We have other sub farms, but I'm here because I'm posted to be here as a Catholic priest. But it doesn't stop me from going to my farm to harvest, come back here and process it. But because people have known it, and they in the label to the product, our number is there. People call us at any time. Sometimes we take it to the bookshop and other place for people to pick there. Yes, we do. Like even roughly a month ago, we did one free here. When I was at Isieke, I also did. I announced it to the church. I called it the post-COVID-19 era. Survival of human race through agriculture. Focus on beekeeping. So people came. I trained them freely. And they just won the first part of the training. We just raised their interest. And some individuals have come, asked me to help them to get the hive. And we are doing that gradually. Okay. And by God's grace also, on Friday, day after tomorrow, I'll be going to St. Thomas Catholic Parish, Aruchukwu. They invited me to come and do big training there. After we show you some of the hive I brought for them, which I'll be taking to that place. Well, it is not capital intensive. If you just want to start, you don't have anything. If you have up to, let's say, 30,000, you can start with one hive, the iron stand, and the basic things. Then when you begin to produce, when the honey begin to yield, as you sell, you cannot increase, because you just need to get the hive. The hive is the major thing. Can get any, if you don't have money for iron stands, can use anything, either drum cut into two or this paint stand, anything you can use to stand it temporarily, and you bet it. When the bees come, when they are attracted, as they develop, as you harvest and make sales, you cannot expand. Yes, with the major number one problem you are having now, challenge is that people are excessively using herbicides and pesticides in controlling weeds and other pests. And you know, these bees are also living to the incense also. So people apply them wrongly and they use the wrong one and it's killing the bees. We are calling on the government, you know, to advise them to know the symbiotic relationship between the beekeeping and what they're doing as people are in agronomy. Because through pollination, the bees will help their cause to do well. So they should be advised, that's number one. Secondly, over there, outside this country, beekeepers are paid for pollination services. our people don't even know the value of pollination. It's just that we plant our crops, we harvest. We don't know what's going on. If they really appreciate what is pollination, they would like to support beekeepers so that we now talk about food security. Because when the bees pollinate any particular crop, there's increase in yield and also quantity. That's qualitative and quantitative increase in yield than what one used to obtain when the other agents of pollination are involved.
Improving the honey production through beekeeping will be a sure way to add market value to the Nigerian economy.
Very wonderful, because as I told you, it doesn't take much to start. Many people sustain their families with beekeeping because a bottle, or let's talk about now, a liter of natural pure honey on the general level is between 4,000 and 5,000, though you can differ from city to city. And if somebody can, within a space of 6 months, if you just started with one colony, you are making not less than, we don't say, when we say 10 liters, it can be more. Less, but a minimum of 10 liters, and you have sold that for 4,000 naira. That's already 40,000. And you subtract the money you use to build the hype, which is nothing. You are making it, and you continue that way every year. So, but I think that most of our young people are still waiting for a white collar job. They don't want to bend. If they settle down, beekeeping can sustain somebody. The international body is interested in Africa. Like 2 years ago, the Nigeria hosted for the first time Happy Expo, which comprised some representatives from US and Europe, and all the African countries there, quartered in Abuja for more than a week for that. So, but our people don't really know that. They just want something that can be very fast. If they can just settle down a minimum of 6 months, 1 year, now you see how you are growing through beekeeping. You can make it.
Researchers linked honey to an improvement in gut microbial balance, coughing, and other respiratory conditions. Because of honey's trace nutrients, the sweetener has been thought to have antibacterial, antioxidant, and anti-inflammatory properties, along with healing potential for ailments such as sore throats, digestive disorders, and burns. But you could be in more danger when you take fake honey.
Okay, fake honey, actually, if you really want to do the analysis, it requires chemical testing in the laboratory. Other things people talk about, if you light, it catches, and other things. Well, those things are sometimes, it's what you just say, that's where they think about it, but it's often a little bit difficult to say this is a fake honey. But if you suspect fake honey in terms of ordinary sugar, refined sugar, if any honey they do with refined sugar, if you put it in the fridge, refrigerator for 24 hours, the sugar will settle down and the water will flow. But on top, but when you are sure that you have a natural honey, there's no need to refrigerate. If you refrigerate, you are reducing the quality. So it is often, if you really want to talk about knowing the difference, you have to undergo some chemical processes that takes like 2-3 weeks to really analyze the content. That's why we are very careful. Most of you see the one they do with molasses and sugar. If you look at them, the same color and sometimes the same test. Well, of course, now it's not good already. Some people are diabetic. The doctor says, please do not take refined sugar, but you can take honey. And they go to buy that honey in quote, not know that it's also sugar. When you fry sugar, it turns brown or molasses. So people who are diabetic, they are taking it, hoping that taking honey is endangering their health more. They'll be diminishing gradually. Yes, you see, I only mentioned about honey and also beeswax. Other byproducts, they're what we call propolis. Propolis, the bees gathered it from the backs of the trees. Sorry, very gummy. And they use it to seal any unwanted entrances or openings in their hive. Now, those propolis now are used by people who are in the dental field. They use it as filant when it's processed. We talk about royal jelly. You know that many supplements contain royal jelly. Royal jelly is a milky substance the worker bees use in feeding the future queen, and is high in protein. That is why some of these supplements contain royal jelly are very expensive. We have also what we call the bee venom. This thing, when it stings you, it pains you. That thing is therapeutic. It is used in treating partial stroke and paralysis and other things. It is a kilo of bee venom. It's not less than $1,000. The white people they value it more. Often they purposely instigate the bees to get it, but often they are made into capsules. We have what we call med or honey wine, which is from fermented honey. If you ferment natural honey, ferment it, it becomes alcoholic and very sweet. Are you following? For those who are Catholics, in abbeys and monasteries in the early history of the church, where the vine could not thrive, the monks, they fermented honey to use as mass wine.
Honeybees are social in nature and often live together in large, very organized and sophisticated communities called colonies. Honeybee colonies consist of a single queen, hundreds of male drones, and 20,000 to 80,000 female worker bees. The number of individuals within a honeybee colony depends largely upon seasonal changes. A colony could reach up to 80,000 individuals during the active season. The queens are the only members of the colony able to lay fertilized eggs. An egg-laying queen is important in establishing a strong honeybee colony and is capable of producing up to 2,000 eggs within a single day. Queens mate early in life and store up to millions of sperm within their body. While they are capable of living up to 5 years, they often only live 2 to 3 years producing eggs.
Okay, actually, if you come to a colony, what makes a colony of bees is the queen, which is always one in a colony, the drone, which are very few, and their major work is to mate the queen, and the worker bees, which are unfertilized female bees. They are the greatest in number. They are the foraging bees, they are the worker bees. They go about getting everything to grow. The drone is just for mating the queen, and they're very few. Often, sometimes when they, after mating the queen, the drone will die. The worker bees, they get it from nectars of flowers and pollen. And when they bring inside the colony, they cogitate it and they deposit it into the hexagonal shape of the comb. And they undergo some processes after a time. As they fan their wing, they are evaporating the excess water content of those things. And after a period of 2 weeks, 3 weeks, the whole thing generally will just turn into the honey. So when you go, you collect the comb, you extract the honey. As you collect the comb, you return the frame. They begin again with another comb. So you just process the honey, separating the honey from the comb, and processing the comb to wax. That's immediately that can come from wax. The queen is just, you know, after mating flight, what do you call mating flight? Because when a queen is raised, after mating flight, the queen does not meet with the drone again. It meets once in a lifetime. And after that mating flight, which is on the air, the queen returns to the colony and begins to lay a minimum of 1,000 eggs daily for the rest of her life, which could be 4 years, 5 or at most 6 years. So some queen will raise between 1,000 to 2,000 eggs on daily basis. And that is why a colony can easily grow. You can get between 60,000 to 80 something thousand bees in a colony. So it's only by one queen.
So you cannot find two queens in a colony.
What happens when the incumbent queen is getting weaker? These things are they're naturally sensitive. They begin to raise another queen cell. And once the new queen is about hatching, the old queen leaves for the new queen to reign. And as it's leaving, it goes with at least half of the colony. Some of the bees will follow the old queen to go. It's not the new that goes, but the old leaves the room for the new queen. So, and as it's leaving, some about half of the colony bees will follow it to enter into a new hive.
Okay, so they form
another colony, yeah.
Okay. Do you know that your body secretes a certain hormone when you're agitated, such that can cause the bee to sting you, especially when you are close to the hive? This means that you must be properly kitted and prepared before the business. It is against this backdrop that we also wanted to know some of the implements that are required for bee harvestation.
The bee suit, see how it is designed? So here is the bag, you put it on, it's very large to cover you. However, it doesn't mean that the bees, when you aggravate them, they cannot penetrate. The venom or the sting can also pierce through this. If you don't realize your mind.
As this is.
Yeah. Sometimes they pierce and you don't feel it, but if you're a beekeeper, see the beekeeper, even when they sting one or two, you shouldn't be afraid. Already that venom is medicine, I said it before, it's therapeutic. But there's another aspect of beekeeping that's known as apitherapy.
Api is from Apis. Apis is Latin, meaning bees. Okay. That's why they call it apiculture. If you don't call it beekeeping, you call it apiculture. Oh. That's the science of keeping bees. So some people are also engaged in apitherapy, where they use the bee products to produce medicine. So this is what you put on. This is necessary, especially when you're going to do thorough supervision. Then, this is the hand glove. You can also wear something like this to cover, when you have to take this, to cover everywhere. This is the hand glove you put on your hand. Now this is the smoker. Without this, you cannot open any hive. You put anything that is well, probably mean that any, maybe like any dry something, you can put it here, like leaves. Then you put fire. If you close it, as you're proper like this, it will produce some smoke. That smoke helps in disorganizing the bees. Doesn't kill them, it pops gradually to disorganize their connection so that they can, you know, operate simply and live. If you just go to a colony without this and just open it like that, when they are very much connected, they can be very much offensive. Yes, this is, we call this smoker bellow. Okay, so this is called hive tool. This hive tool, if you want to open the, you know, because of the propolis, I told you, the propolis sticks the frames together, very firm, because they don't want to leave any place open. So you use this to help you to, you know, shift the frames. It's very necessary. This is a brush. If you lift any comb that has honey, and you can use this brush, very soft, to remove some of the bees around it, so that what you put into your bucket, whatever, is just ordinary honey, you don't put the bees there. So you don't use another hand to brush them there. You have, and this, we are using the one that is very soft so that not also harm the bees.
But Father, commercial honey that we see some things inside.
One, two things.
Okay.
Is that some people, they put it to convince people that this is bee. Sometimes they go to hives, some like a pesticide to kill the bees, and they put the bees that way on top of what they have used, you know, the sugar they manufactured, to convince people that this is honey. Remember, in that process, they are selling two poisons. One, that they are selling sugar, refined sugar, to somebody. And they also, they use the pesticides to kill the bees, to put as an evidence of this is a natural honey. And that time had also contaminated, and somebody takes it in a worse situation. Again, to some people who can also go to the wild and get the natural honey, because they are not trained, they don't know how to process it, to sieve it properly. Yeah, from that. So this is what you call the beeswax. I process this one. After the last harvest I did, that's the comb people normally throw away in the bush, and when they go, I process it with this one. This is what we call the wasp. People who are into textile industry, they buy candle, polish, and other things, they buy it. But often I use it as a attractor because it retains the aroma of the honey. Just the aroma of the honey for a longer period. If you melt it like candle and spread it inside the hive, it will tend that the bees will come trying to lick it, they discover that place habitable. So I use that as a bet.
Okay.
Yes. Let me just show you the hive proper. This one is the one we call the Kenyan cobra hive. It was, you know, popularized in Kenya. These are bars. This normally where they build, they fix the comb, and it takes this shape of funnel. So that whenever I want to harvest, when I feed it, I leave this one like this and put it in a bucket and scrape it with that hive tool, and I will return this. So this one is called Kenyan Toba hive. This one is Langstroth. Langstroth hive is known as the most modern beehive. Because we call it Langstroth, we named after an American clergyman known as L. Langstroth. He looked at the way that these bees build their comb on top of the trees, and what we call the bee space. The space, this thing that for the purpose, so that the bees can operate between this hive movement, we call it the bee space. So that's an innovation brought about L. Langstroth. That's why we named this hive after him, Langstroth Hive. So we use also this one. So this and this are the major.
This one, the bees build their comb.
They build up here, exactly here. So that if you want, you just put it and scrape and return. The essence of this opening here,
yes,
you want to fix artificial comb, that and that thing, to help the bees, because the bees takes them about 3 good months to build the comb. So sometimes people also use this beeswax, process into the same shape, hexagonal shape. So you can fix it already. If you fix it and the bees come, the first 3 months they will use to build that. So they are giving them foundation, they now do faster. But if you harvest, you don't scrape. You use a centrifugal machine to extract this one while you still turn it with that fixed artificial comb. That's also on the advanced level of beekeeping, which we're also doing here.
So this is our final product.
Oh,
okay.
So far.
Yeah.